Hello, my friends. I want to read a scripture from Matthew 16:18. And I say also unto thee, that thou art Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. I want to speak about the body of Christ, the church, the global church. From time to time through history, there's always been a fight against the body of Christ. Of course, the enemy hates the body of Christ. He hates the plans that God has for the church, that we are going to raise up in splendor and glory and really be his bride here on this planet. So he's fighting that. And right now, there is a major battle on this planet against the body of Christ. As you know, that many nations have shut down the church buildings. It's so extreme that even, I heard it yesterday, some places, they are not even allowed to sing worship songs. Only the worship leader from the platform can sing worship songs, because they believe that when they are singing, a little bit of that virus can come out of their mouth. It's totally ridiculous and it's super demonic. It's the enemy that's behind that thing to push and quench, sorry, quench the church and the fire and the flow from heaven and the worship and the prayer. Because he knows that when we are standing up and pray, marvelous things will happen. But you see, the church will always survive. In the first Christians, they had to live in the catacombs, and they were living there their whole life. And they were persecuted in Rome for their belief system. They were martyrs. But still, the church maintained to survive. You can't quench the Holy Spirit completely from this planet. Not until we are in the rapture. That day when we are in the rapture is going to be really dark on this planet. Actually, people, it's because of us and the church and the body of Christ and all the Christians on this nation that are praying that this world is not a living hell. For many people, it is a hell. Yes, many nations are struggling with poverty, with wars, and a lot of bad stuff is going on, and it's going to get darker. So we have to follow the scripture about what's coming. But don't give up. What we need to do is to pray. And when we are lifting our voices, because the church, the body of Christ, it says here, the gates of hell will not prevail against it. The word prevail means that there is no power on this planet that can quench the church. It cannot destroy it. It will find ways to survive because God is with us, people. So even if you can't be in a church building right now and you can't even lay your hands on somebody, which is also ridiculous. I mean, the blood of Christ is more stronger than any virus. God's name, Jesus' name, is above all the other names. His name is greater than COVID-19. So when we are seeking God's face in this time and praying, the church will survive. Trust me, it's in the Bible. It will survive. It has been through a lot of storms on this planet from time to time, but it will always survive. There's something, because God is putting his hands on his people. He has promised us that the church will survive. so it will survive in one form or another. If we can't pray inside, we're going to pray outside, right? God is going to make a way where there is no way. He's with us. So don't worry about the church building, because the building is actually in our hearts. And you know, we can be outside. We can have little Bible groups in our homes. It's thousands of things we can do. God will give you a creative plan to just continue having church in your way. So I believe when we start praying on this level, there is a cleansing coming to the body of Christ. And the cleansing is going directly into our hearts, into our motives, into our belief system, our blind spots, as I've spoken about in here before, where God wants to clean and purify each and every one of us. I know that the blood is cleansing us, that we are standing in front of God's throne like sin has never existed because of grace. But yet there is also a sanctification and a holified people that God is raising up, because he wants us to bear fruit. It's not enough to surf on the wave of grace. Yes, you got saved and you saved by grace and you stand in front of God and you are forgiven for all your sins when you repent. But on the other hand, there is another form of salvation where we are daily working on our salvation by crucifying our flesh. And there's so many layers in many of us that we don't know about, where we can be self-deceived, where something in our system can be so it can be so deep in our core that we have adjusted to a certain way of being, but God, that is sin, for example. Something you have allowed yourself to do over many years of your life, like watching stuff you shouldn't be watching, or maybe exaggerating when you tell people what you're doing, which become lies. And all these things are going to come up to the surface. You see, when God's glory hit the earth, as it is going to do now, when we pray, we are dragging down the glory of God. And that lamp, as I've spoken about in here before, will start shining on every area of our lives. We can't point finger at anybody else all the time and not see what's in our own life. So God will turn your finger, your accusation towards others, towards yourself. Not that you should accuse yourself, but that you should go on your knees and seek God earnestly to show you if you have blind spots and be humble. You see, God is raising up the prophetic ministry now and the apostolic for real. Yeah, this is the apostolic time we are entering into. And the apostolic and prophetic ministry, they are operating in that power of exposure also. So I believe there will be a lot of exposure of darkness right now. I see it already happen in the world, in many cases in the secular world. Hidden stuff, nasty stuff about pedophilia and abuse, sexual abuse. A lot of bad hidden stuff is now coming up to the surface. Why? Because it's God. Because we are entering into this exposure time right now where God wants to cleanse. He's giving people who have been living in sin a second chance to repent from their nasty stuff, so they can come to heaven. Isn't that a fantastic thing from heaven to do? That even if a person has been living very criminal, almost all his life. God is still giving those people a chance to repent by allowing what's been hidden underneath is being shouted on the rooftop now. And I can see it already. And it's also going to happen with other stuff, with people in churches that have wrong motives, that are they have titles that were not given to them by God. They've given themselves titles. It's going to be a shift where those people are going to be replaced with other people who are anointed to be in those positions. Because God is order. Is there one thing that God blesses above everything? It is order in his church. And that's what he's doing right now. Order of God begins with that he exposes everything in our lives and in the body of Christ. He takes out the hidden stuff, the shadows, the dark spots. He shows them to us now. So we have a chance to repent because he wants us so much to come into our destiny, our calling, that he called us before the foundation of this world. When we were in God's heart, before we were in our mother's womb, God already planned what you and I were going to do on this planet. But you see, life is coming also towards our lives with a lot of temptations, and we get hurt, and we experience a lot of stuff that does something to our view. So suddenly we have the wrong glasses on and we think we're right with God. So God is shaking everything that can be shaken right now. I think he allows what's going on. He's not sending COVID-19, absolutely not, but he is allowing some of these shakings to take place, and also in our personal life. I can feel it, you know, I can feel that there are areas of my life that I thought were right with God for many years. And all of a sudden, when I tap into the Holy Spirit in a deeper level now, I see stuff in my life that shouldn't be there. I see a way of speaking that I shouldn't have done, and I need to repent from those things. And I do it really quickly because I'm so aware of that if the enemy finds doorways in my life, like a little crack in my wall, he will take advantage of those holes in my wall. So when I see it, I know it's grace because I want to cooperate with heaven. I want to live in repentance in my personal life, and there is no time to be proud now. That's just very immature and not wise, people. To be proud and to not receive correction from the Holy Spirit, or maybe God send you a prophet. If you have been dealing with sin for a long time, God will send a prophet in your way, and he or she will correct you of your hidden sin that you are denying, and you don't want to admit that you have those spots in your personal life, because you thought that no one would notice, no one would see it. You see, the Holy Spirit sees everything, and he's given us all grace. Grace is also that he gives us time to repent. A long time, actually. I mean, years. But if we continue living in a path that is ungodly, or we have issues in our lives, like lies or unclean things, perverted stuff that you don't think anybody know, and you continue doing those things that are sins, and at the same time you expect God to use you in a mighty way and to send you out to nation, he can't do it. He can't do it until he has cleansed you. So this time here is a cleansing time for us. It's mercy, actually, to be washed by God, to be cleansed. So if you are in a situation today where maybe a prophet is coming your way, and that is grace, and he or she is saying something that is very uncomfortable to you, listen and obey and be humble and take that word. Because I believe that God sends the prophet at the end of something. After the prophet has spoken, there is some kind of judgment or heavy consequence for your rebellious way of living. So God really wants to cleanse us, people. He really wants us to cooperate. And many times we have to allow him again and again to be the potter in our lives. If you have been living with Christ your whole life, you think that, oh, I've gone through so many processes and, you know, I know myself and I'm all cleansed. And still, there are stuff in our lives that God wants to go deeper on because he's order. And why is he coming with this truth about us now? Because now we are ready to receive them. And now God says, enough. You can't live like that anymore. I won't allow you walking around sinning like that and call yourself a Christian. I won't allow you to walk around and lying to people and manipulate people for years. You can't do it anymore. Now you're going to be corrected by heaven, for example. If you have been living in sexual sin, perverted stuff, hidden sin, proudness, rebellion, and you think it's okay to have that attitude, you think it's okay to be manipulative and lie to people about your life, God is going to correct you. I know I'm a little harsh today, but I feel I'm speaking under the anointing of God here about his order, where we all need to bow down for his will for our lives. After all, we said to God that he could have our lives. And he took us seriously. So when we said to him, you are our lords. You are our lord, sorry. You are our master. You can have my life. I mean, God took you seriously and he really wants your life. Every part of your life he wants. And he wants to sanctify every part of you, glorify it, cleanse you, anoint you, and restore your life, heal you completely from the past. And then he's going to send you out and use you in a mighty way. That's his plan. All of this is love. It's love to be corrected by our Father. Just like a parent will do when he sees that his son or his daughter are deceived, are going in the wrong direction. They don't know what's best for them. The father will stop them and say, hey, you can't, don't go in that direction. It's dangerous for you. And often if we have hidden sin and it's going to be confronted of somebody prophetic or by the Holy Spirit, we will react with rebellion. Because there's proudness there that make us so, we need to be humble. That's what I'm trying to say. When God is correcting us, we need to bow down for the will of God, all of us. Me, you, everybody else. It's not another way, you know? And to cooperate with the Holy Spirit and be fast to repent from things that we didn't see up till now. But God sees everything and he wants to cleanse us and he wants to really raise up his bride. So if he shows you something today, just be very fast on your knees and repent, my precious sister and brother. Don't be rebellion against the correction of God. Don't try to be self-righteous, because he is your righteousness. You died, remember? You said to him, I will die from myself and I want to you to take over. You see, the more you are dying from yourself, from your ego, your proudness, your motives and everything, the more you are dying from that, the easier it is for you to live in humbleness and cooperate with the Holy Spirit when he corrects you. Because you are workable like clay that he's been shaping for a long time. Your life is in his hands. And it's also protection, but it's also that he's working on us to make us more like him. To make us shiny and glorious and pure. He only wants to use pure vessels, people. We can't have hidden motives. We can't have self-righteousness, self-promotion, superego, unclean things, lying spirits, manipulative things in our life. We can't have it. God is going to go very close to those things in our lives now to wash it out. So I know it's a little humbling to experience that. I mean, if you're a minister in here and all of a sudden somebody come and prophesy to you something that's, you know, you don't want to admit it, but it's stuff you had for years in your life. And it's kind of make you it's humbling to see that there are still things inside of you that needs to bow down to the will of God. Because we have a flesh. We have a flesh and we can be tempted and we can be self-righteous and think we got it now. That's proudness. And you know, that attitude of being like jealous or competition with your brother and sister, or you want to be in the center. You don't like that other people are used by God because you want to be used by God. And you're jealous and you envy people. And those things are the rotten fruit that God needs to take out from the body of Christ right now. So he can raise up and dress his bride with his glory clouds. It's time to cooperate with heaven. And then the power will be mighty over us people. We will be used in a mighty, mighty, mighty way. I believe we're walking into a really supernatural time with miracles that you can't even see them in the Bible. Jesus said that we should do the same works as him and bigger. We're going to do more than what Jesus did here on this planet. We're entering into one of the most prophetic, end time, supernatural time in this history. And that's why we need to be corrected by the Holy Spirit. So we know that we are pure, that we are cleansed, that there is no hidden agenda for the enemy. There is no self-deception in our soul. There is no proudness. There is no rebellion. There is no unclean. Everything is clean. The motive is clean. And we live in love towards each other. We're not competing with our sister and our brother. We love them. We want them to grow in Christ. And we're just helping each other to reach the goal for each and one of us. To go into this time together, holding hands, not fighting against each other about the positions, holding hands, people, and love one another as Christ loves us. Have a wonderful Monday. I will come back tomorrow, hopefully, and I just wish you a great night and just stay in the presence of God. It's the best investment you can do right now. It's just to pour, just to connect with the Holy Spirit and live in His presence, live in His throne room. Take more time in prayer and invest in fasting and praying and interceding and be obedient. And let Him show you. Be humble. Ask God if there's anything you can't see that's inside of you, that you are self-deceived in a way. Let the Holy Spirit show you. And if somebody correct you from God, be humble to receive it. It's a message from heaven to make you grow and come into your calling on this earth, so you can be used mighty by God. Amen. I love you guys.